Hello my dear students, welcome to your social science class. Today we are going to discuss about some major crops of India, problems faced by Indian farmers and technological and institutional reforms done by Indian government. So let's start.
We all know that India is an agriculturally important country where 2/3 of India's population is still engaged in agricultural activities. In India, a variety of food crops and non-food crops are grown in different parts of the country depending upon the variation in soil, climate and cultivation practices. So, let's discuss some of the important major food crops in this module. Let's discuss about wheat. It is the main food crop in the north and the northwestern part of the country. This rabi crop requires a cool growing season and a bright sunshine at the time of ripening. It requires 50 to 75 cm of annual rainfall. There are two important wheat growing zones in our country. They are the Ganga Satluj Plains in the northwest and the black soil region of the Deccan. The major wheat producing states are Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Punjab, Bihar, Rajasthan and parts of Madhya Pradesh. Next main food crop of our country is rice. Our country is the second largest producer of rice in the world after China. It means China jo hai wo pure world mein number one producer hai rice ka. Uske baad hamari country India aati hai second number par. It is a kharif crop which requires a high temperature above 25 degrees Celsius and high humidity with annual rainfall above 100 centimeter. It is grown in the plains of the north and the northeastern India coastal areas. It is also grown in West Bengal, Punjab, Haryana, parts of Rajasthan and western UP with the help of canal irrigation and tube wells. The third main important food crop of India is मेज, जिसे हम हिंदी में मक्का के नाम से जानते हैं. इट इज़ यूज्ड फॉर बोथ फूड एंड फॉडर, मतलब चारे के लिए भी इस्तेमाल की जाती है और खाने के लिए भी. इट इज़ अ खरीफ क्रॉप विच रिक्वायर्स टेम्परेचर बिटवीन 21 डिग्री सेल्सियस टू 27 डिग्री सेल्सियस. इट ग्रोज़ वेल इन ओल्ड एलोवियल सॉइल. द यूज़ ऑफ मॉडर्न इनपुट्स सच एज HYV सीड्स, fertilizers and irrigation have contributed to the increasing production of maize in our country India. We all know that agriculture has been the backbone of Indian economy, but from the year 1951 its contribution to the GDP is declining. Ab agriculture ke contribution ke decline hone ke reason kya hain? The main reason of this is the problems of the farmers. So let's see what problems are faced by the Indian farmers. The first main important problem or the challenge is international competition. Indian farmers are facing challenges from international competition due to decrease in import duties. The second main important challenge is reducing public investment in agriculture. Government is reducing public investment in agriculture sector, particularly in irrigation, power, rural roads, etc. The third one is decrease in subsidies on fertilizers. Subsidies on fertilizers have been decreased, leading to increase in the cost of production. The next is non-availability of agricultural inputs. Another one is non-availability of labor and costly wages. The next, price variation in market and exploitation by middlemen. The last one is impact of climate change and many related issues. To solve all these problems, our government introduced some institutional and technological reforms. So let's discuss about these reforms. The first one is collectivization, consolidation of holdings, abolition of zamindari were given priority to bring institutional reforms in the country after independence. The next one, land reforms were the main focus of our first 5-year plan. इंडिपेंडेंस के बाद जो पहला हमारा फर्स्ट 5-year प्लान इंट्रोड्यूस किया गया उसमें मेन फोकस लैंड रिफॉर्म्स के ऊपर दिया गया. हाँ, ये बात अलग है कि इम्प्लीमेंटेशन इतना इफ़ेक्टिवली नहीं किया गया, लेकिन लैंड रिफॉर्म्स की कोशिश ज़रूर की गई। द नेक्स्ट वन इज़ द ग्रीन रेवोल्यूशन एंड द वाइट रेवोल्यूशन वर सम ऑफ द स्ट्रेटेजीज इनिशिएटिव टू इम्प्रूव इंडियन एग्रीकल्चर। प्रोविज़न फॉर क्रॉप इंश्योरेंस अगेंस्ट नेचुरल क्लैमिटीज़। द नेक्स्ट वन इज़ ग्रामीण बैंक्स, कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटीज़ एंड बैंक्स फॉर प्रोवाइडिंग लोन फैसिलिटीज़ टू द फार्मर्स वर एस्टैब्लिश्ड। किसान क्रेडिट कार्ड एंड पर्सनल एक्सीडेंट इंश्योरेंस स्कीम्स वर इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द गवर्नमेंट फॉर द फार्मर्स। द गवर्नमेंट ऑल्सो अनाउंस्ड मिनिमम सपोर्ट प्राइज एंड प्रोक्योरमेंट प्राइज फॉर इम्पॉर्टेंट क्रॉप्स टू चेक द एक्सप्लॉयटेशन ऑफ फार्मर्स बाय मिडलमैन। इट मीन्स सोइंग सीजन से पहले ही जो इंडियन गवर्नमेंट है, या आप कह सकते हैं फूड कॉरपोरेशन ऑफ इंडिया, मिनिमम सपोर्ट प्राइस फिक्स कर देती हैं कुछ इम्पॉर्टेंट क्रॉप्स के लिए, सो दैट फार्मर्स के एक्सप्लॉयटेशन को रोका जा सके। द लास्ट वन इज़ यूज़ ऑफ HYV सीड्स, फर्टिलाइजर्स, इंसेक्टिसाइड्स, पेस्टिसाइड्स, हार्वेस्टर्स, थ्रेशर्स एंड ट्रैक्टर्स वॉज प्रमोटेड।
At the end of the chapter, I hope all the concepts are very clear to all of you. So read the chapter once again. Do your work properly. Stay at home. Stay safe. Thank you.